Hello, BookTube. My name is Elizabeth and I read bouquins and books. And this is my weekly wrap-up. I don't think it's going to be very long because I haven't read that many books. I finished two books, which is above my average, but one of them I cannot really talk about because it's for the BookTube prize. I've also started two other books, but one of them does not exist in English, so I don't think I will have much to say about that one either. However, this is what I've read this week. I've finished Our Bodies, Their Battlefield by Christina Lamb. This is for the BookTube prize. I will say that I'm very happy to have finished reading this book. I said last week that I was not enjoying the read because it's such a harrowing subject. It's gut-wrenching. It's page after page of women testifying about being raped. It's very, very difficult. I cannot say anything about that. Shut up. I cannot say anything about that. So I'm happy I'm done with it. And to escape this terrifying subject, I decided to go south of France and read Bruno, Chief of Police by Martin Walker. It's a mystery that is on the cozy side. One thing I didn't like was that I could not escape this book, unfortunately. There are two reminders of the book on rape in this. In Our Bodies, Their Battlefield, there's a chapter about rape during World War II. For a long time, it was not talked about. We didn't really know what happened. But after I would say the Soviet Union collapsed and probably the archives opened up a bit more, we learned how extensive it was, Soviet troops raping German women. Or I say German, but they could have been Polish, Ukrainian, or whatever, any woman that they met. And that was put up to light by historian Anthony Beaver. And the blurb on the cover of the book is by Anthony Beaver. So that was not fun. And another subject in this book is the Balkan Wars between Serbia and Bosnia and the ethnic cleansing that the Serbs did against the Bosnian women. And on page 133, it's not a spoiler, by the way. Felix had been with him when they first found the decrepit motel that the Serbs had turned into a brothel for their troops and had rescued the Bosnian women who had been forced to service them. So, no escape from that. It's not the author's fault. Normally, I love those coincidences. I love it when a book that I'm reading reminds me of a completely unrelated book that I'm reading or that I've been reading. However, in this particular case, I would have wished they hadn't been there. But besides that, besides those two little mentions that have nothing to do with the content of the book, in fact, it's very good. I really liked it. It's one of those cozy mysteries that send you right away to a different place. It feels like the south of France, and I was in the south of France, and it was a lot of fun. There's a lot of wine, of cognac. There's pâté and foie gras and cheese and millefeuille. I was totally hungry when I read that. I liked the characters. They were very nice. I liked the main character. I think he's more or less built so that women like me will fall in love with him. He's an exemplary citizen. He is implicated in his community. And somehow he knows what's the right thing to do. He has a charming dog and everything like that. So it's enjoyable. And also, I found out that they are all on script. So the entire series is on script. So I will definitely read that, read the rest of the series. Probably not right away because I like to space things out. And when I know that I have a good series, I like to keep it in reserve for when I need something to escape. Yes, they're all available on script. One of the questions I was wondering when I was reading was whether if it was situated in a real town or a fictional town. The name is fictional. It's in the fictional town of Saint-Denis, but the indications given were real. It talked about being at the place where the Vézère and the Dordogne rivers meet. And there's a town at those are two real rivers that actually meet, and there's a town in there. There's a town of 3,000 people, like Saint-Denis. It's, like it says in here, 20 kilometers away from a town called Lalinde. There's a road leading to Périgueux. There's another road leading to Les Aisies. On one side of the river, there's the old part of town. On the other side of the river, there is the new part of town. And it fits perfectly the description of this Saint-Denis. So I think the real Saint-Denis is Le Bugue, L-E space B-U-G-U-E. I haven't checked on the internet whether it's confirmed by the author or not. I'm just convinced by my research on Google Map that, and with the pictures too, it completely fits the description of the town. So it's set in a fictional town based on a real town. So I had a lot of fun trying to figure that out. The intrigue is well constructed. The characters are credible. And on the whole, I really like it. If you like mysteries on the cozy side, this is a good one. And if you like the south of France, it's a good one too. So I recommend from me. What I've started now. This is for Caribathon. It's Quand il fait triste, Bertha chante. This is the one that is not translated in English. It was published late last year, so I don't know if it will be translated in English, but at the moment it's not. So I will not talk about it very much, except to say that I'm about two-thirds through, and I really like it. It's not a gripping story, it's a bit of a slow burn. It's the author talking, well, sort of talking to his mother. His mother dies at the beginning, and his way of grieving is by writing her a letter to tell her story, to tell the way he perceives her story. So, and I like the language a lot. It's well written. So that's a good read for me. And the other one that I'm reading is Thoughts of Sorts by Georges Perec. It's a collection of essays. Since it's a collection of essays, it's hard to summarize. So I cannot really talk about it much. I will just talk about one of the essays that he wrote. It's one that was published in 1978, and he talks about the art and manner of sorting your books on your bookshelves. And he comes up with 12 different ways of sorting your books, and one of them, I like the fact that one of them is there. So the 12 ways of sorting your books. Alphabetically, so he doesn't mention if it's by title or by author. By continent or country. By color. By date of acquisition. By date of publication. By format. By genre. By literary period, by language, by reading priority, by binding. So I suppose that would mean either paperback or hardback, or perhaps by how the spines look or something. And by series. And the one that I'm happy to see is by colors. I was tempted to think that sorting books by color was created because of BookTube and Instagram and social media in general. But apparently in 1978, a serious author thought it was a valid way of sorting your books on your bookshelves. So if you want to sort your books by color, go ahead. Georges Perec agrees with you that it's a valid way of sorting your books. And what I'm going to be reading. So what I'm going to be reading next week is this one, Notes on a Silencing. It's another book for the BookTube Prize, and it's another book about sexual assault. Hey, hey, yay! it's another book I would not have chosen for myself, but I think that's one of the good things of the BookTube Prize, it forces you to read books that you wouldn't have read necessarily. And in some cases, I've made discoveries. So the subject might not be super enticing, but it doesn't mean it won't be a good book. So I'm looking forward to reading this. And that's all I had to say. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you had a great reading week and that you will have a great reading week. And see you in the next video. À la prochaine!